What's up, YouTube world? Talk to you guys today about finding two mentors that you should follow. You should have only two mentors to get you to the final level where you want to be. You might have course corrections, but there should be no more than two major mentors in your life. One thing that you should always be looking for in a mentor is someone that is actively doing what you want to become. I was once told, find someone that has what you want, do what they do, and you will get what they got. And if they are actively pursuing, chasing, and making it happen in the area that you so desire to be in. So if you want to be a multi-millionaire in the clothing industry or the lawn care business, you find someone that is a fashion designer or someone that has a department store chain or that has a successful clothing small clothing store that does millions of dollars, where they can be a millionaire, a multi-millionaire. But it's not always that you have $1 million in the bank. It's that you are a millionaire, multi-millionaire on paper. I know quite a few multi-millionaires that are cash broke, if you will, as an explanation or something to describe them, because they have all their money invested in their real estate. See, once you have your money in real estate, it's tied up in the houses, it's tied up in the buildings, and technically you don't need a bank to give you the money, because you got the house, the real estate properties, the commercial properties, and the banks know that you have that collateral. That is as good as the bank saying yes, yes sir, and you get a signature loan, or you go talk to the right banker to get you in the right situation so you go to the next level. But once you're in real estate, you're following a successful real estate investors. And you have to find those people. They're not always easy to find. Not all of them are willing to mentor you. But I believe it's so important to have not 22, not 30 people that you listen to, because it's kind of hard to listen to everybody that's spouting off the same stuff. It doesn't mean that you can't listen to Brian Tracy or Zig Ziglar or I think his name's Robert Allen, multiple lines of income. You work hard, you be the best person you can be. You work harder than the next person. You work harder than anyone else out there, but you're following mentors that are actively doing it, that they're in sales, that they're in production, that they're in creating social media links, creating content, creating stuff on Twitter, YouTube, Google+, Facebook, any social media source that will drive traffic to you, not just a website, not just a landing page, but to you, so you can keep your head down. And in 10 or 15 years later, that you have money in the bank or a real estate empire where the money is working for you. you're no longer in quadrant E, which is the employee, but you moved up past the, I think it's the business investor, the business person, which is the self-employed individual in cash flow quadrants by Rich Dad, which is Robert Kiyosaki. Then you move to the next level where you're the entrepreneur, where you have a business, a real business. You got employees working for you, that you got it all going on for you, that you're not the only employee in your business, that you're self-employed. If you get hurt today, that you're in the hospital tomorrow, and who's paying your bills? Okay. So you have multiple employees, 4, 5, 10, 30, you know, whatever it might be. And you move on to the next level of cash flow quadrants, to investor, where you're not even in the business anymore. You're back, you're advising the business to go and grow. And you might be, at that point, a mentor to someone. And you're doing it daily. You're showing people how it's done. And you're growing, you're sharing, you're all that great stuff. It's so important to take your goals, your dreams, from just being an employee, and you move into the different quadrants, the cash flow quadrants, and you grow. You grow on a personal level. You work your demons out. You stretch them out so thin that they're so thin that you can't even see them anymore. They're not there. They're not in the way. That's the bottom line. You grow on a personal level where your mentor, that may have retired by the time you get to his level. Some people never want to get out of the game. They love working every day, making deals, creating content, having someone follow them. And if that's you, that's great. Because there's so much more to happen. So much more to grow. And if you like this content, you like what I have to say here, check it out. Have a great day. And check us out on YouTube, Patreon, and other social websites. Check us out on Twitter, the big old Google Plus, and stay tuned for more content. Talk to you soon.